Welcome back to the show, everyone. I'm Kathy Hobbs. Brooklyn has long been on the map for foodies as Manhattan chefs have crossed the East River. Our Brooklyn real estate expert, Donald Brennan of Brennan Real Estate, takes us to a favorite neighborhood eat in Windsor Terrace. Hey, Donald.
Thanks, Kathy. Right now, I'm at the East Wind Snack Shop in Windsor Terrace, Brooklyn, an undiscovered gem in the midst of a long-established neighborhood. Founder, Chef Chris Cheung, is someone who took the entrepreneurial leap and has been rewarded with hundreds of fans willing to cross the bridge in order to taste his Chinese-inspired food. Let's come inside. Chef Chris Cheung knows his way around a kitchen. He has worked in some of the top restaurants in the city, from Nobu to Georges and Ruby Foos. Now he's making his mark with his own restaurant, East Wind Snack Shop in Windsor Terrace, Brooklyn. Owning a restaurant is hard. What made you want to go out on your own?
Yeah, I agree. Owning a restaurant is very, very difficult to do because you have to love it. If you don't love it, it's not going to work out. So the pinnacle of what you want to do in your career ends up being owning, so you can kind of call your own shots and you can be as creative as you want and you could do the things the way you feel that they should be done.
Right, so you've been at this a while, but can you tell us actually how long? And also would love to hear about some of these accolades that you've received, great praise from all around.
Yeah, I've been in the business over 20 years, so started out a while ago, worked my way up the ladder with some really great chefs. This past year, we've received a lot of accolades. You know, we got a New York Times review, highlighted by great publications like Brooklyn Magazine, New York Magazine, Edible Brooklyn. I've done my share of food TV.
Sure.
I've done some things for the Food Network, done some stuff with Anthony Bourdain, hung out with Martha Stewart on her show. The Museum of Chinese in America gave me an award for an outstanding service in my profession, and that meant a lot to me as well. So, yeah.
Excellent. These days, Chef Cheung gets to experiment with the menu like he couldn't when he worked for others. The result? What has been called some of the best Asian food in the city. Chris, how'd you come up with the name East Wind Snack Shop?
Okay, so funny story. I actually had a different name. My partner at the time was very superstitious, and so am I. So we had a name picked out, but she wasn't too happy with it, so she went to the Chinese fortune teller, and the Chinese fortune teller gave her this name. Yeah. And so who am I to argue?
Sure, of course not.
Yeah.
Go with it.
Yeah.
Well, it sounds great. It's a great name. Can you tell us a little bit about your influences on your cooking style and menu choices and so forth?
Yeah, so we're Chinese, but that means a lot. And my influences come from a few different sources. So I'm Toi San, and I grew up in Chinatown. So I was around that style of food for many years growing up as a kid. But I learned dim sum from a Hong Kong dim sum master as I was coming up as a chef. And then also my wife, she's Shanghainese. And I went back to Shanghai with her a few years ago and cooked in the villages in Shanghai. So all those things kind of coming together have totally influenced my food. When we first started here, it was like a 20-item menu. You know, we were gonna have some fun with the food, do some nice things, and then we had lines out the door, and we couldn't keep up with the demand. So I had pretty much shorten the menu a little bit, and it turned into a focus on doing just a few things really, really well, all handmade, all from scratch every day. Yeah. And dumplings became a big part of that. Dumplings was something that the neighborhood wanted, and we focused on dumplings. So I kind of call it chasing the perfect dumpling, and I've gotten pretty far with it.
So about your experience as a cook, pretty impressive track record. Can you tell us about where you had worked before you set up your shop here?
Yeah, so I've had some really fun times cooking with and for some really great chefs. I opened Nobu back in the day, so I got to work with Nobu himself and Miramoto, so the Iron Chef, you know, who's kind of done so much since then. And that was really, really great time opening that restaurant at the time when Nobu wasn't a household name and, you know, you know, we kind of started the whole thing.
Sure.
I worked and I opened John George's with John George.
Wow.
And so, you know, my partner on the line happened to be Wiley Dufresne, who is one of the iconic top chefs in, you know, in the world.
Excellent location here. Can you tell me a little bit about why you chose this spot to open up your restaurant?
Well, yeah, I live only a few blocks down, so the commute is great for me, but there's no better place for me to be than here. It's a really great neighborhood, love the people. Brooklyn is an established food community already, and you know, so far I'm having a lot of fun with it, so.
Great, yeah. Excellent. So many great, unique, and interesting neighborhoods in Brooklyn.
Yes.
What's special about Windsor Terrace?
What makes this neighborhood great is really the people. It's such a warm, comforting, homey type neighborhood. It's a small neighborhood as well.
And how does that play into your decision about location?
Well, I mean, you know, every neighborhood's got their charms, and you know, even have these guys hanging out. Terrace's got a lot going for it. It's, you know, the real estate prices are you know, increasing, you know, every year.
Yeah.
You know, you get, you know, these beautiful brownstones and these beautiful buildings.
Yeah.
Like I said, the people are great, and you know, the location is really cool. I mean, it's very accessible from the highways.
Yeah.
We have the F train station right here, so.
Yeah.
You know, easy to get to,
yeah.
And you know, everybody enjoys that park. So
yeah.
You know, lots of things to come and hang out and do in Windsor Terrace.
So a little overcast, rainy today, not a great park day, but what a fabulous neighborhood amenity. Can you tell us a little bit about Prospect Park here?
For us on this side of Brooklyn, Prospect Park is the center of the universe.
So where does all this go? What do you see for your future?
Well, you know, there's no limits, actually. You know, our plan for worldwide domination, you know, is in the works. But it's really just staying true and keep making great food, and the rest will come.
Not too far from more established restaurant scenes like that in Park Slope, Brooklyn, Chef Cheung has succeeded in putting Windsor Terrace on the map as a destination for those willing to hop on a subway in order to experience some great food. I'm Donald Brennan of Brennan Real Estate. Back to you, Kathy.
Thanks, Donald. A trip to Windsor Terrace seems like a delicious way to spend a visit to Brooklyn. When we come back, we take on a massive staging job, reimagining a Tribeca loft just in time for spring selling season. When we come back.